Welcome to our panel building workshop, where we explain the art of panel building.
Today we're going to touch the topic of heat dissipation in your cabinet. In other words, which products to use and where to place them in your cabinet. Hank, I would like to discuss with you the temperature control and heat dissipation in such a cabinet, because I got an awful lot of questions from people about how to do this. How much power is there in the cabinet and how much does it dissipate and when do I need to do cooling? I feel this one is already quite warm, it's on for some time. What's in here?
Well, you're surprised, huh?
Yeah.
Because this is a control cabinet.
Yeah.
And a control cabinet is always on. Let's have a look what is inside. Nothing is inside.
It's not
seems
nice.
To be.
Yeah.
However, if you look closely, you will find
power supplies.
Power supplies. A CPU.
Yeah.
And you find an HDMI.
Yeah.
And two small
switches.
Switches.
One for Ethernet and one for Ethernet.
So how much power consumption, how much heat does it give you is always difficult to find.
Yeah.
So if you're going to look inside or you're going to feel
Wait. I'm not a fan of going with your hands into a panel that's turned on. And this one is switched on. There's 230 volts AC in here.
Yeah.
So I've got a much nicer gadget for that. It's a thermal camera. And with this one, you can really see the hotspots. So let's have a look. It looks like, the power supplies are quite hot. And here the CPU is hot. What you definitely see is that also the cable duct on top is getting hot. And that means the wires in that cable duct are getting hot also. So it's not good. So
no.
It derates your cable also, and also the current you can put through that wire.
The wire is an antenna, and the antenna is from copper, and copper guides the wand.
So the hot ones were the power supplies?
Power supplies.
And the CPU?
CPU.
And we have the switches?
Switches and the HMI.
Aye.
And make a fast calculation, it's about 10 watts.
Yeah, 10 watts, we say 10
Two
watts.
Times.
2 times 20. 10 for that power supply. And I think the CPU, and there's
also about
big Intel CPU in there. So that is also 10 watts.
It's 40.
40. And this one?
The big one is also, that is 40 watt.
So it's total already at 80 watts. And then we have two switches, let's say 5 each.
Yeah.
So 90 watts in total.
How to get rid of this?
Yeah.
Quite easy.
The panel itself?
Ventilator.
So two things.
Two things. One, this one is getting 27, 29 watts.
Yeah. So
leaves
absorption. Leaves you 60 watts to get that you need to push out of the cabinet.
Exactly. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, well, here you are going to blow the air in, the ventilation is going up, that way out. If you look closely, you can see all kinds of free space. In this case, the air can go around it.
Mm-hmm.
And since all the products are much smaller, the airflow that gets around is much better. If you look at those products, really, really small. And of course, much less power consumption. Of these products.
From these solid state relays, I know they dissipate only 50% of what the previous model did.
Yeah.
So that's a lot for such a thing.
Yeah, and the other stuff also. So if you then want to know much more about power consumption, you can go over to the power management system where you can measure all the current is going in the cabinet and going outside to the other sub cabinets.
So you know total power consumption of your whole setup.
Yes.
So this concludes this episode. If you have any more questions, just have a look at our support portal, myomron.com. If you can't find the answer there, just create a ticket.